Well, farmers set a new record. The USDA released their January crop report, and Indiana is among the Midwest states finishing very strong this growing season. News 10's Lindsay Yates has more on the record year for crops and what it means for Wabash Valley farmers.
The numbers are in.
I've got some ground that normally would make 140 bushel, and I'd be tickled to death, made 180.
Making 2014 a record year for Hoosier farmers.
That translates into quite a bit bigger yield, almost a third more yield.
Indiana corn production topped 1 billion bushels for the second year in a row, and soybean production was above 300 million for the first time.
We had a lot larger yield, so had more to bring in.
As an unusually cool summer allowed the plants to mature.
Had plenty of moisture. The poor ground responded tremendously.
While the weather was ideal for growing season, the same can't be said for harvesting, a task SHU is still trying to finish.
We just couldn't string 2-3 weeks together like normal. I think the best we had was about 6 good days of harvest in a row.
On top of that, abundance has kept prices low.
From $7 to $4 is almost 40%, but you don't see a 40% increase in yield.
And with potential for farmland assessment and property taxes to go up, many farmers will struggle to make a profit this year.
Taxes are going up. They will not be coming down as the corn price comes down.
And the amount of work doesn't go down either.
You know, we're working on 2015, even though we're still kind of finishing up 2014.
In Clinton, Lindsay Yates, News 10.
An Indiana Senate committee has endorsed a measure by farmers. It aims to once again postpone a property assessment change that could send farm taxes even higher.